this video is sponsored by VideoBlocks. When putting together a video like ours, having access to a wide variety of stock video is incredibly useful. With over 3 million videos, After Effects, and motion backgrounds to choose from, VideoBlocks is a great option and has one of the fastest growing royalty-free stock video libraries out there. They are also the only contributor marketplace that gives 100% of the commission back to the creators. Plus, all of these clips come with royalty-free agreements, so there's no risk of copyright claims. If you are a video creator, VideoBlocks is a great tool to have access to. They are giving away a free 7-day trial so you can try it out and get access to this large royalty-free collection for free. Start your 7-day free trial by going to videoblocks.com/YouTube and get 7 days of VideoBlocks for free. Before I begin making my own cosmetics from scratch, one key ingredient I want to collect is the red dye derived from a small insect, the cochineal. Native to the Americas, these insects were discovered and used by the Aztecs and Incans to dye their clothing. Then, when the Spanish arrived, they began exporting it around the world as a popular red dye. Today, new synthetic dyes have supplanted its use in many areas. You'll find it as a red colorant in many food products, as well as lipstick. Back when I traveled to Mexico for my previous series on making chocolate, coffee, and tequila, we also made one other stop to collect this unique bug. I met up with Manuel, who showed me how they raise and harvest the cochineal bugs. I'm here in Oaxaca with Manuel, who's going to show me the whole process for raising cochineal. So the first step is to cut the cactus that they live on?
Yes, it's necessary only cut for this area.
So after you cut it, you need to dry it, and then you can use it in the greenhouse?
Yes.
Each of these spots, something new would grow from?
Yes. Maybe one plant, one root.
Yeah.
Or maybe one fruit. You like to see how to clean the nopal?
Yeah. To safely handle the cactus, they carefully brush it to remove all the tiny prickles.
It's more easy.
Yeah.
Touch.
So these are not ready for the cochineal then?
Yes.
Once the cactuses are harvested and cleaned, it's time to introduce the bugs. 200 eggs and 20 females in one pouch can yield up to 40,000 hatchlings.
This one. Exactly.
The egg's in place, we then attach it to the cactus leaf.
Normally, the cycle of the cochineal is 3 months. When the baby born, the baby get out of the net and walk on the nopal for two days.
Okay, they come out of the holes?
Yes. And start to eat. Start to absorb the juice of the nopal. Metabolize and transform it in a red solution. The color of the cochineal is not the blood because the insect don't have a blood. No.
Okay.
The solution and the chemical name is carminic acid.
Carminic acid?
Yes.
Okay.
This carminic acid is protect to the another microorganisms.
Yes. Okay.
The male is very different.
Yeah.
And transform it in a little mosquito.
But only the male turns into a fly?
Only the male. The male in outside only live 3 or 5 days.
Okay. So they just reproduce and then die?
It's time to party. And the male, the quantity of the color is very tiny. It's not interest to me.
But all the color is from the females?
Yes.
Okay. It can take up to 140,000 bugs. Add up to enough for 1 kilogram of usable dye.
And I obtain this kilogram for 600 or 1,000 cactus.
The cochineal, do they only eat the cactus? That's the only thing they eat?
Yes, only the nopal.
Yeah.
Not exist in another plant.
So after they fed on the cactus for 3 months, what do they look like?
Would you like to see?
Yeah.
Please.
So how do you harvest these guys then?
It's very simple.
Yeah.
I take the nopal and use the brush.
So how many are usually on and on one cactus leaf like this?
Maybe I collect 3 grams.
3 grams?
The 3 or 4 grams.
Can I try?
Yes, yeah, yes. It's...
Ah, very gently?
Yes.
Come off pretty easily.
Carefully.
The harvested cochineal bugs need to dry out for several days, and then it's time to process them. After harvesting the cochineal, Manuel demonstrated the traditional way that it can be crushed and used to dye clothing.
The alum.
Thanks, Manuel. I now have my cochineal. It's ready for the next step of turning it into a dye. I just gotta figure out how to get out of here. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe and check out other content we have covering a wide variety of topics. Also, if you've enjoyed these series, consider supporting us on Patreon. We are largely a fan-funded channel and depend on the support of our viewers in order to keep our series going. Thanks for watching.